Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the PORWC Taco Bell Cup Series Winston All-Star Race. This is going to be an awesome event, ladies and gentlemen. 40 laps around the Lowe's Motor Speedway in preparation for the All-Star Race. This is going to be 40 laps of pure racing, one winner, 22 starters. Let's take a look at the official starting lineup. That was your starting lineup. As you saw, Nick Bilardo is on the pole. Nick Bilardo won at Texas. Texas, a track similar to Charlotte. Let's get those most famous words in motorsports.
Drivers, start your engines!
As you can tell, that sounded a lot like Arnold Schwarzenegger. And here we go as the cars roll by. For 40 laps of exciting racing. 40 laps of exciting racing. Nick Bilardo on the pole. Ryan Cooper second. Trevor Warwick third. Here you go as you see them as they're coming off of turn number two here at the Charlotte Motor Speedway in Charlotte, North Carolina. This is a great night for All-Star Racing, ladies and gentlemen. It is clear, it is cool, and it is going to be exciting. You got the safer barrier here. We got two rookies on the inside line. We are getting ready for what should be an exciting event. Pace car is off. Nick Bilardo bringing him down at just under 60 miles per hour. The green flag is out. We are racing here at Charlotte. And I forgot to mention, pit stops are on. So this could be a fuel mileage 40 lap event. As Nick Bilardo gets the early advantage, as he leads lap number one, right behind him is rookie Trevor Warwick. Julie Carroll has fallen back to last, along with her Dale Earnhardt Incorporated teammate Charles Jackson. I don't know if that's some kind of strategy or what. As we move ahead towards the front, Robert Wagner, he got in the All-Star race via naming that song and from the second race that I had. We head back up towards the field here. Nick Bilardo still leading. We have an onboard camera of the 67 of Jordan Morris. Let's listen. Figure out what's going on with the 8 and the 15 as to why they're in the back. Let's get a report. Let's go down to our pit reporter for this.
Well, as you see, the 15 and the 8 car down on the, are down far back. This is a strategy between the two of them. They are hanging back in the back to avoid any trouble. They know that they're going to have to play it safe on fuel, so they're going to stay in the back and they're going to see how it all plays out. But back up to you, Mark.
Well, thanks a lot, Dan. That was a pretty good pit report down there as we are going back up towards the main pack. These cars have been broken up into two packs. You see Zach Goldbeck, who got in by winning at Talladega. Brandon Phillips, who won at Martinsville. And the front cars are single file now. As you see, the top speed being set right now is Nick Bilardo at 200.294 miles per hour. Actually, take that back. The fastest lap time right now is Brody Talley in the 97 car. Now, Brody Talley in the 97 car with a 26.204. As you see, these cars are starting to get spread out here. See with the lap info here. The 8 and 15 car better hope that the pack doesn't catch them. It actually looks like there might be something wrong with them as Nick Bilardo has pulled away. We are still caution free. As Trevor Warwick is trying to fight his way back up to second spot, but it looks like is getting passed on the inside by the 32 of Jared Magoon. Now he looks like look at Andy Tran. He's going to try to pass on the inside and make it three wide. Andy Tran on the inside of Jared Magoon. Now look at this. We got Thomas Magoon now passing Jared, and now he's going to try to go for second. This is allowing Nick Bilardo to pull out to a good lead. As you see, these two are well off the pace. They could be saving fuel. These two are probably saving fuel to see how much longer they can make it. See how long they can make it. We got 40 laps here. They may pull a one-stopper. This could be either like two or three pit stops. It all depends when these guys start breaking down for pit road. As you see up front, it's still Nick Bilardo, Thomas Magoon, Jack Richards, Jordan Morris, and Brody Talley. I believe that has been, correct, your top five, as they are racing two and three wide behind them. Come across the line here. Yep, Trevor Warwick, Jared Magoon, Michael Norman, who made his way up into the top 10, Andy Tran, and Dylan Poteet round out your top 10 for that lap. And from if we look on the back here, we still got 2x2 action right here. Still pretty good here. The front cars, who are single file, have begun to break away. Nick Bilardo has been caught. Thomas Magoon has run down Nick Bilardo. And look, he brought the 5 car with him. These cars have still refused to break away and gone down the pit road. These guys are slowly catching this 8 and the 15 car. I don't know if there could be something wrong with them. They're all well off the pace. Everyone else is running above 200 miles an hour on the straightaways. These guys in the back are only running 180 to 190 on the straightaways. There could be a slight problem for both of them. We have no clue what the problem is, if anything. Oh, look at the 5 car. Jack Richards pulls to the inside to try to make a move on Thomas Magoon in the 99. We are quickly approaching the halfway lap, and with the way this looks, this could be a one-stop race. Wait a minute, Nick Bilardo's coming down the pit road. Nick Bilardo coming into pit road. Nick Bilardo is the first person to break off into pit road. Nope, Charles Jackson's in pit road as well. Charles Jackson, who may have had the initial problem, comes into pit road. He's gonna get 4 tires. Yep, he's getting 4 tires as the A car comes on the pit road. Nick Bilardo's on pit road. Here comes the rest of the field. Almost the rest of the field now is gonna come down pit road. Dylan Poteet is the only car that has not come down the pit road yet. Oh, wait a minute, it looks like the 22 car has some damage. James Stone has some damage on his car. Coming down, look, the 18 car has some back end damage. That might be where it came from. As Nick Bilardo is coming back on the track. And then here comes everybody else down pit road, exactly on lap 20. Dylan Poteet, we're coming to 20 laps to go, ladies and gentlemen. This could be a fuel mileage race right here. As they all come out of pit road, this will probably give Nick Bilardo the point, or the lead, as he comes by. We'll have to see where he comes out in accordance to when everybody gets up to speed. He's gonna fly by these cars on the outside. Alright, let's see where he clocks in as he comes across the line. Jack Richards may have the lead. Jack Richards may have the lead as they come across the line. Let's see. Yeah, Jack Richards has the lead. But not for long. Let's look at the 16 car. 16 car. A dominant car. Pretty much all race long. It's trying to get on the inside of the 5. He's trying. The front 3 cars are spread out now. A caution would bring these guys back up together as they are quickly approaching lap traffic. The 5 of Jack Richards is going to try to get under. There he goes. He's going to put Julie Carroll 1 lap down. The pit strategy between the 8 and the 15 didn't quite work out. As the 5 car is going to go by Charles Jackson in the 15 car. We are on lap 2440 here as we're going to scroll through the field, I guess, right here. The five, Jack Richards is in first. Nick Bilardo's in second. Thomas Magoon third. Jordan Morris fourth. Dylan Poteet fifth. Michael Norman sixth. Robert Wagner seventh. Thomas Magoon eighth. Rick Norman ninth. And Dylan Magoon in tenth. And then the 1 is in 11th, Zach Golbeck 12th, Brandon Phillips 13th, Andy Tran 14th, Eric Matthews 15th, Jared Magoon 16th, Ryan Cooper 17th, James Stone, who has some front end damage, is 18th, Austin Talley 19th, and Trevor Warwick is 20th. And then the 15 and the 8 are laps down. Okay, let's take a look at the lap times here as you see everybody here. The car is still widespread out as we just had pit stops. We're coming up on 10 laps to go. Jack Richards is still leading. But he's got company. Company. Eleven laps to go. Who's gonna be able to have enough to win this race? Is still open. Here's the thing though, who's gonna have to come down pit road? Who's gonna save enough fuel? Who's gonna have enough fuel to make it to the end? Nick Bilardo's pit crew were not quick enough to get him out into the first spot. They had lost some time. Jack Richards' crew had rocketed him from about maybe fourth from the pit stops to first after the pit stops. As speaking of Nick, he has already moved up to the second spot. Nick's got some company as well. He has Jordan right behind him. Five cars still with a good lead. He has a 3/10 lead over Nick in the 16 car right now as they head off into turn 2. Cars now starting to get single file around the track as the 67 takes a look underneath the 16 car going into turn 4. Jack Richards is loving this because in his mirror that means they're racing, and if they're racing that means he can pull away. The 97 car settles in behind Dylan Poteet in fourth. Now can Jordan Morris catch up to the back of the 5 car within the allotted time, as we have 6 laps to go. 6 to go. Oh, there goes Dylan Poteet to the inside of Jordan Morris for the second spot. This is exactly what the 5 car needs to see. Jack Richards, who got into the All-Star race via being in the top 10 in the point standings. Jack Richards looking for his first win of the season. It may not come out of a points paying race, but it'll come at Las Vegas nonetheless. Wow, did I just say Las Vegas? I meant to say Charlotte. Here they come. They're coming out. We have 3 laps to go. We have 4 laps to go. And look at that. The 17 car has caught that number 5. He has caught him, and he has no problems from behind. This is going to be a great race between the 5 and the 17. 3 laps to go. There he goes, right there. He's going to make the move onto the inside. Now here's the question. Can he get it, and can he keep it? Dylan Poteet rockets to the front. Dylan Poteet, who won in the Bristol race to get into the field, now gets to the front and is just rocketing away. Does he have enough fuel to make it? 2 laps to go, as I saw somebody coming into the pits. Ryan Cooper's in the pits. Julie Carroll's lap down. Charles Jackson, who's a lap down. Austin Talley's in the pits. James Stone. Jordan Morris. Zach Goldbeck. They're coming in the pits. Is he going to have enough? He's trying to save. White flag. 1 lap to go for the 17 car. Does he have enough fuel to make it? Can Dylan Poteet get his second win of the season? He's going to have lap traffic to contend with up front. Here, he's going to make it. He's going to ride behind the 8 car. The 8 car is going to hold him up, but it's not going to be enough. Dylan Poteet wins the Winston. And the quote-unquote $1 million that goes with it. What an awesome race to the finish. I don't know why Dylan Poteet went up behind the 8 car. That could have cost him the race. But nonetheless, it was good for a win. Dylan Poteet has won the All-Star Winston race. I can't believe I just said that backwards. The Winston All-Star race. Let's take a look at our official race results. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen, your official race results. We have Dylan Poteet, Brody Talley, Jack Richards, Robert Wagner, Rick Norman, Dylan Magoon, Michael Norman, Thomas Magoon, Alan Dong, and Eric Matthews, your top 10. Andy Tran, Brandon Phillips, Jared Magoon, and Trevor Warwick round out the cars on the lead lap. 15th is Jordan Morris. 16th, the dominant car of the day, Nick Ballardo. Tough break for him as he had to pit and fall. And he fell 1 lap down. Zach Goldbeck, Ryan Cooper, Austin Talley, James Stone, Julie Carroll, and Charles Jackson, who the 8 in the 15 car had horrible days today. Absolutely no clue what had happened. We will have to hear more from the drivers of those two machines to see what exactly happened that caused them to have this terrible day. Well, ladies and gentlemen, for the Winston All-Star Race here at the Charlotte Motor Speedway, this is Michael Norman. This race has been presented by Taco Bell. Think outside the bun. And join us next time as we go for the Coca-Cola 600.